Auto.
Do.
Yes. Ha. Rest my gully dome. It is in fact spooky season.
Yep.
Third, actually. All right, new game. Normal.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and is what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Hi! Alright, let's do this.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me.
Yes, I'm streaming.
And dark and weird.
That's okay.
So yes, it began with a dream.
Hi, Zay! Oh! I've been good.
He was dead. I was convinced they put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Hi, Wolfie. Yeah, I wanted to do something spooky.
I could hardly stand my feet.
Alright, look up at the light. No. Okay. Shift to sprint, alright. There's the lighthouse.
I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Oh, what? Oh, shit. What the fuck?
A single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories, cause I'm gonna kill you.
What the fuck?
It's not like your story's already good. Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap frills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me!
Look at your work!
Oh, Lord. There's a QR code. Hold on. Do I have a QR code reader on my phone? See. It didn't work for you? Oh. Weird. I'll come back to it, I'm sure. Alright, let's get to the... Yay. Oh, that was weird.
You missed your deadline.
Okay, how do I...
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
Well, that's not weird. Okay, that's also weird. Oh my God. Oh, this is okay. Go across the bridge. Okay, well maybe I won't get to go back. Ah.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
Yeah, but how? Okay.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
Okay.
Your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. But it feels you coming. It will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take a light. Flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it.
still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Okay. Okay.
I will give you back your dream now.
Where are you? A terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Okay. This is not easy. Okay, pick and choose my battles, okay. Awesome. Oh, well, I died.
I can keep this up.
Almost made it to the lighthouse. Yay, I did it.
just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Okay, welcome to Bright Falls. My watch is telling me I've been sitting for too long. Not even settling in. You literally, you're still on the ferry.
Local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up when you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. Forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. Took it out of the window.
And to keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
That's a little weird, but all right.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah.
enough work it says.
Of course you do.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
What are you doing? Okay, maybe I have to go around the other way? Okay, that's not weird at all.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Oh, go in there, Gordon. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it now.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find stuff to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Even if you found it.
Change the bowl. This is what happens when he gets
up. Okay, there's the women's bathroom. And the dogs are barking.
Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken down. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Oh, that's not creepy at all. I wish the dogs would stop barking.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This window ought to be fixed. And then I must get them on Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Yeah, sorry. I'll try to mute myself when the, bye, Rose.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Of course you did.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh, that's...
That
okay.
A real nut house.
Okay.
To be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman?
talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
That's okay. Hold on. Audio. Oh, great. I might get a copyright claim. So. Oh, the video sound, the game sound is too low? Alright, I'll fix that. Alright, that should be better.
Gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, alright.
Also,
don't
I need
worry,
to turn
I'll
subtitles on.
I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got
options, audio. Nope. Subtitles. Enabled. There we go.
Flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
I would not feel comfortable spending any time in a cabin on a rock. Hello, Raven. Bird leg cabin. Okay.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Oh, I will move that. Hold on. Make some minor adjustments.
Come on.
Alright, hold on. Alright, let me move. Nope. Move that up there. And make that a little smaller. There we go. Alright. Let's see if that helped.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing.
Come on,
come on,
honey. Get the door open so we can get a look inside.
The door is open. Shut the fuck up.
Hello? Anyone here?
Yeah, I found a thermos. Alright, let's see. Let's go upstairs.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Ugh.
Damn.
Well, okay.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Okay. Oh dear. All right, hold on. Let's... All right, move that. Let's make that smaller again. Alright. There we go. That should do it. How's that? Okay. Oh, I didn't mean to go back in there. Okay, so power's not in the house.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my favorite writer.
Well, Rose,
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Maine on KBFFM. And now, some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
All right, let's see. Let's try. Maybe there's a back door. Oh, that was the back door.
Shed over there. Alan, honey, can you open the door?
My power's in the shed. Thank you. Something I needed to examine. Where?
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Where do you figure that?
There's probably a fuse box or a generator in the shed.
Okay, thank you, dear. I'm so good at video games. Oh, there's the door.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Yeah. No, you're not complaining too much. It's important for me to know these things. Sailor. What? It's not gonna let me look at the cellar?
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Okay.
Door.
Alice? Honey?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Oh, is it sexy lingerie?
Ooh. Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Ow.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice, you. Everyone.
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not. Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice!
What the fuck?
Damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
You are a dick. He is a dick.
Alice? dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Where are you? Help! Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming! Oh, no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Okay.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Okay, pro tip, don't do that. Okay.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Okay.
Damn.
There goes your car. Rosebud, stop whining.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh no. Manuscript craved. You can press on F5. Okay.
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
I like that it reads them to you. Wolfie, can you take Rosebud out?
Yeah, I guess.
Oh, no.
There? Please, I've been in an accident.
I we reached a checkpoint.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Okay.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl... Ducky,
pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Read that in a minute. Oh. Very Shining.
Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Oh.
During your... trying... it's the latest
thing.
In...
Testably
proven help let you
shoot
one
stone.
You can see the sun.
I wasn't about to open the door as long as I was liable to catch an axe with my forehead.
Stone.
Same
time.
So what do I do? This call for help is what it says. Okay.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff's Station.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, there goes the power line, or the phone line.
This is bad.
Oh shit, this is bad.
Fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Okay.
Eerie hand. hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Okay. That may be... Nope. I think I just wasted my flare. Yeah, I definitely wasted my flare. Well, here's an opportunity for me to read that manuscript piece I found.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Okay, go to the other side. All right. Hold on, let me see if there's anything in here.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Yeah, reach a checkpoint.
It's rabbit season!
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Okay.
What was that?
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Is that their way of saying the character can't swim? Did I fall in a hole and get stuck? Okay, no, I didn't. Am I going the right way? No, I think I just went in a circle. Ah, there's the gas station. Okay.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Okay. Interesting. Okay, let's see.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Good, 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 good. Yeah, reach checkpoint. Does that say caution? Proceed at your own risk. Logging area ahead. Okay. Okay. Did I go in a circle again? I went in a circle again. Dang it. I think I know what I need to do. Okay. Okay, here we go.
Taken. They're taken.
The taken are filled with darkness. Awesome. Nope. I hear breathing. Okay, so that's not something I can do. Careful. Okay, where do I go from here? Still not open. Okay. Okay, the gas station's that way. So I need to go that way. Oh, I hurt myself.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Yeah, I figured it out, and the dogs are barking again. Yay, a thermos.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Okay. Spoopy. This is going away from where I need to be. Hurry back. Yay, I found the generator. Oh, crap. Cheese and crackers. Aha, I figured it out. I am the smart cookie. Oh, and I'm not that smart. I fell. And I fell again. I'm not good at this. Haha.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night I had. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather's absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio.
makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walk.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rumbling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find him.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog? Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Ooh, I'll get a shotgun. Awesome. Ooh, another manuscript page.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Oh, wrong way. It feels like I'm not getting any closer.
The gas station was closer now.
Oh.
Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no contest.
Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
This is just so weird. Oh, that didn't go well. Okay. Let's see what this says.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Well, at least we know what's fixing to happen. I'm confused. Did I go the right way? Yeah, I think that was the right way. Okay. Oh, shit.
Touch salad, though. A man like me needs a house.
That's for the day.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Yay. Oh, shotgun. been sitting for too long.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses.
Well, alrighty then.
Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
Well, that was entertaining. Okay. Well, look, moths. Okay. Okay, well, pro tip. Watch out for other enemies.
It can be
dangerous.
It requires
is gonna be hard. Oh! Okay. Let's switch to my shotgun. I forgot I had a shotgun.
You might think it can be
dangerous.
It requires patience. The engine takes to cool.
Come on. This is too hard.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive.
Okay, well that was interesting.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Oh, there's a manuscript.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Okay. Let's see what the manuscript says.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Okay. Hi! Hello. Okay.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Wonder where I heard that before.
I'm
keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities. Raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, and surprise competitions. Live music for children. Bucktooth Charlie, afternoons. And Montgomery the Mystic's Amazing Phantasmagoria, evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest Parade.
Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Okay, so I think I've finished the first part.
Clown they call the Sandman.
Yep.
Tiptoes to my room every night. And just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper.
End go to episode sleep. One.
Everything is alright. I close my eyes.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
All right. I think that's gonna be it for today. Thank you all for stopping by. Oh, cause I need to start cooking dinner here shortly. So, thank you all for stopping by. I'll be back tomorrow, and what am I playing tomorrow? That's the wrong tab. Tomorrow, we'll be playing Human Fall Flat, me and my roommate Stormy, unless he decides not to wake up, in which case I'll play something else. But, thank you again, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye!